Today you will be examined for the mark of mastery. Not one, but two of the Keyblades chosen stand here as candidates. But this is neither a competition nor a battle for supremacy. Not a test of wills, but a test of heart. Both of you may prevail, or neither. But I am sure our guest, Master Xehanort, did not travel all this way to see our youngest prospects in years fall short of the mark. I trust you are ready.
Yes.
Then let the examination begin.
On the exam.
But Ben, you're in danger here. Go wait in your room.
No way. I've been looking forward to this. Seeing you two become masters. I'm not gonna miss it now.
He could take care of himself. He's been out there training just as hard as us.
Yeah.
Stay sharp, Ben.
That was unexpected. But one must keep a still heart even in the most trying of circumstances. It was an excellent test, one I chose to let unfold. Which brings us to your next trial. Now, Terra and Aqua, the two of you will face each other in combat. Remember, there are no winners, only truths. For when equal powers clash, their nature is revealed. Begin! We have deliberated and reached a decision. Terra, Aqua, you both performed commendably. However, only Aqua has shown the mark of mastery. Terra, you fail to keep the darkness within you sufficiently in check. But there is always next time. That is all. Aqua, as our newest Keyblade Master, you are entitled to certain knowledge. Please wait here for further instruction.
Hey.
Terra, I'm sorry.
The darkness, where did it come from?
What do you make of Ventus?
He ain't gonna cut it. Somebody's gotta break that loser in.
Not here, you won't. I have to keep up appearances.
I know that. He just needs a little incentive to leave home.
Uh, Sorry. But I need some time alone.
And in so much as you are now Keyblade Master, you must always be conscious of... What is that?
What happened?
I don't know. Why isn't Ven here?
Very well, then. I will send my pupils to investigate. Yes, I understand. Farewell. That was my dear old friend Yen Sid. As you know, he is master no more, but he still keeps a close eye on the tides of light and darkness. His counsel serves as signposts on the road we wielders of the Keyblade must walk. All the more reason then for concern, for he tells me the princesses of heart are in danger. Not only from the forces of darkness, as you may assume, but also from a new threat, one that feeds on negativity. Fledgling emotions that have taken monster form. Yen Sid calls them the Unversed. As wielders of the Keyblade, you are tasked with striking down any who would upset the balance of light and darkness. The Unversed are no exception. I tried to pass this news on to Master Xehanort, but my repeated attempts to reach him have failed. I doubt there is any connection, and yet this all troubles me.
Master Xehanort is gone?
So here we are. I need you two to get this situation under control. Eliminate the Unversed, and find Master Xehanort. I have unlocked the lanes between. You may use these forbidden pathways to travel between this world and countless others. The darkness looms closer than usual within these spaces, but your armor will protect you. Lastly, remember that order must be kept. You cannot tell anyone there are other worlds. Now go, and fulfill your duty.
Yes, Master.
Terra, consider this an opportunity. A second chance for you to change my mind.
What?
You must know, I care for you like my own son. If I could have my way, I would name you Master in a second. But how can I? When you are so obsessed with power. Terra, you mustn't be afraid of losing. Fear leads to obsession with power, and obsession beckons the darkness. You must never forget.
Thank you, Master. I swear, I will not fail you again.
Master, I best be on my way.
Wait, Aqua. Before you depart, I have one other, well, call it a request of the utmost priority.
Yes?
I told Terra this could be a second chance to show the mark of mastery, and I meant it. However, that flicker of darkness he displayed during the examination, I can sense it runs very deep. If those powers were to prove too much for him to handle, I want you to bring him back to me at once. It's for his own good. I could not bear to lose any of you to the darkness.
Of course. I would never let that happen. I promise you I will bring Terra back. Only this time, you'll see he has what it takes to be a master. He's not as weak as you think.
happened? You have to bring him back.
Don't worry, Master.
Mademoiselle! Señorita! Wait!
Aqua!
Terra! Terra, Ven ran away from home.
What?
I think he left to go find you. Do you have any idea why?
No. Actually, just before I left, he tried to tell me something. I should have listened to what he had to say.
Oh. So, did you manage to locate Master Zaynort?
No, but it seems he's looking for pure hearts filled with light.
Pure hearts filled with light?
All I can tell you is that his search hasn't taken him here.
All right. I'll stay and see if I can find more clues.
Okay. The prince is in the ballroom ahead. He might have some answers.
Thanks.
Aqua. You still have the same dream?
Well, yes.
There's this girl here. Her name is Cinderella. She made me realize how powerful it is just to believe. No matter how impossible things seem, a powerful enough dream will always be enough to light the darkness. If you see her, give her my thanks.
Will do. He'll be all right. You won't give into it.
Thank you.
Who are those ladies?
Oh, if I recall correctly, that is Lady Tremaine, and those are her daughters.
There was something very wrong about them.
You came back.
Huh?
Oh, my apologies. I was mistaken.
Your Highness, I found this on the palace stairs.
A glass slipper.
One dropped by a lovely young lady, and I'll search far and wide to find the maiden to whom this belongs.
You will?
Of course, Your Highness. After all, you've finally found someone whom you wish to marry. Upon hearing that happy news, your father, the king, has decreed that a quest shall begin immediately throughout the kingdom, and I will start with the closest residence, that of Lady Tremaine.
Lady Tremaine. I'd better pay her a visit.
Yeah! honor our humble home, my lord.
Quite so.
May I present my daughters, Grisella and Anastasia?
As I feared, there is darkness here.
Wait! It's dangerous to fight the darkness with light, my dear.
Who are you?
Cinderella's fairy godmother. I appear to those who believe that dreams come true.
Then I'm honored. But why would you advise me not to fight darkness with light?
Strong rays of sun create dark shadows. Sadly, Lady Tremaine and both her daughters are jealous of Cinderella's charm and beauty, qualities that appear to you as light. Jealousy is darkness. Light and dark go hand in hand. You can't have one without the other.
Then, what should I do?
It's quite simple, dear. One of Cinderella's friends is trying very hard to keep her light from fading. I want you to join little Jacques and help him.
I can do that.
You'll need a bit of my magic to help, Jacques. Come back and see me when you're ready. Bippity-boppity-boo!
Just missed Terra.
Can't understand why. It always fit perfectly before.
Quite enough of this. The next young lady, please.
Oh, no. Hear that? Gotta flurry. Flinderelli, gotta try that flipper. Come on, come on, flurry. No. That's a gotta flurry.
It's all right. Leave this to me. Jack, don't lose that key.
Yeah!
You're the only ladies here?
There's no one else, Your Grace.
Come on, hurry, Jack. Be all right if I tried on the glass slipper?
I met you at the palace. Unfortunately, you are not the young lady the prince is looking for.
But I am a girl. I should at least be given a chance to try it on.
Who are you? And what are you doing in my house?
She's probably here to rob us.
Mother, do something!
That girl does not live here. I have only two daughters. I believe we're finished here, Your Grace.
Regardless, she means no harm. Here you are, my dear.
Jack, hurry.
Your Grace, please wait. May I try it on?
Pay no attention to her. She's just an imaginative child.
Madam, my orders were every maiden.
You should let her go first.
Thank you.
I actually want to thank you for teaching Tara he needs to keep believing.
What will I do?
Please, don't worry. You see, I have the other slipper.
Perfect fit. I must inform the prince immediately. You will come with me, of course.
I'd be happy to.
It's not fair. She's a scullery maid.
Mother, are you just going to let them leave?
No. Cinderella will be put in her place.
What happened? Where is Cinderella?
She was attacked by a creature, a monster in the forest.
A monster?
This is what happens when you go against my wishes.
The darkness in their hearts overtook them. Go.
Thunder!
Pure heart filled with light? It's strange. The master taught me darkness needs to be destroyed. But how, if not with light?
Oh, my dear, you're too young to know. Experience more things, and you'll find the answer. Just trust in your dreams.
Thank you.
What has happened here?
Poor Snow White. She was just as sweet as could be.
She sang us pretty songs.
And made us smile.
At bedtime, she told wonderful stories. About falling in love and the prince she met.
And when we went to work, she gave us all a kiss.
She was so full of kindness. Why, she made better folk of all of us.
From what you've said, she must have been very loved. But how did this happen to her?
A wicked queen was horribly jealous of our dear Snow White's beauty. So she used her evil magic to change into an old hag. Then she gave Snow White a poison apple.
And by the time we got here, well, it was just too late. We found the princess as still as can be. Nothing we could do would wake her.
Isn't there some way we can help her?
Well, not unless somebody craves the basil. I'll brave the castle.
No, you fools can stay here doing nothing. But I'm not afeard of going, not even to that witch's lair.
You'll never make it. The castle's supposed to be guarded by magic and crawling with monsters.
All right, then I'll go.
You will?
I will. Leave it to me.
Well, all right, my dear. We'd be much obliged.
Thank you.
Is something wrong?
This